I wanted to talk for a quick second today about mindset work. Mindset work is phenomenal. It is incredible to be able to understand where your brain goes in certain situations and be able to shift out of that current mindset you're in that maybe it's ineffective or not working for your life. However, what gets left out of the conversation is the fact that in order for us to actually shift into a more effective or positive mindset or way of being or behavior, we must be out of survival mode. This is where the industry does a huge disservice to people, is that we talk about mindset, we talk about personal development, we talk about growth, we talk about strategies as if it's so simple. You just have to change your mindset. You just have to shift how you think, change your thoughts, change your life. And to some extent, that is true, but we really cannot change our thoughts or reprogram our thoughts until we are in a safe body. A safe body requires a nervous system that feels safe, that is out of hypervigilance, that isn't in fight, flight, freeze, or appease. Somebody that is anchored in a safe body is able to use the higher faculties of their brain where all the reprogramming and all the choices happen. Now, if we're not in a safe body and we're in a hypervigilant or survival body, we're going to be making decisions out of that same state. That happens in the back of the brain in the amygdala. Now, this is why it's so imperative and so important to understand two major factors about the nervous system. We've been hearing a lot about nervous system work. A lot of people are starting to talk about it and talk about the importance of regulation and safety, which is phenomenal. But there's two main components we must talk about. Number one is having that awareness that you're in a survival state and being empowered to bring yourself back to a sense of safety and regulation. That's number one. The second goal when it comes to nervous system work is expanding your window of tolerance, which means expanding the range of what your capacity is. So a lot of people will practice number one and they'll say, okay, I've got regulation tools. I'm doing all the things. I'm finding myself in a safe body. I feel empowered. Yes. Amazing. Great. And now that you feel empowered to do that, we must learn how to expand our capacity, expand our range so that we can expand what we're able to hold in life. And when we think about growth and transformation and change and success and next levels and all the things that most of us in personal development are wanting to build towards, we have to talk about the set point that is your nervous system. A lot of times we're unable to build past our current set point of abundance, of success, of recognition, of love, of intimacy, of vulnerability, because yes, we may have regulation tools, but we're not practicing expanding that window of tolerance, putting ourselves in situations that are safe but stretchy, and finding new set points of safety in those situations. This is why my husband and I created The Bridge. This is in all the work that I do, but in particular in person, The Bridge experience is built for this. It not only teaches you how to be in your body, how to recognize what your body does, almost becoming a scientist, an observer of the intricacies of your body from a non-judgmental standpoint. We're all humans. We all have our things we do, but then empowering you to find safety and then putting you in situations that you can't beat, putting your nervous system in situations that are safe because they're controlled in a container that we put together, but they stretch you. They push you to that edge. They're expanding you outside of your current comfort zone to build a bigger capacity and a bigger window of tolerance. We do this slowly, we titrate, and we re-anchor in safety at all these points. And that is why when people leave our workshop, which is 2 weekends, Bridge Experience and Extreme Leadership, they go, oh my God, I feel so different. I feel like a brand new person. It's because we shatter what is at the foundation of your identity. Most people, they'll do identity work and they're like, okay, that's going to change it. But we got to change the thing that formed the identity, which is your nervous system. We have to expand what your system says, I'm capable of being with that. I'm capable of holding something like that because I have an expanded window. So it's not that your life changes, because life is going to keep doing life things, but you change in the face of life. Who you become in the face of challenges is so much bigger, so much more expanded, so much more grounded in the face of what used to set you off and put you in survival. So if you're like, well, Bridge sounds amazing, I would love to learn more. Well, comment Bridge below and I will DM you some information about our upcoming trainings. We've got one in July here in Austin. We've got one in October in Australia. We've got another another one here in Austin in January, and it is something that is not to be missed. It is literally two weekends that can change the entire scope of your life, because you're not just changing up here. You're not learning more and writing more notes and understanding more concepts and distinctions. You're actually learning about your body and what your body does when it gets into scenarios. Then how to expand the capacity of your body so that you have more range. Anything you want to do, whether it's being a more awesome parent or being a better partner or being successful in whatever it is that you're building. No matter what you want to do, your body is at the foundation of everything. So it is time to train that.